and then I'll show you how to make idli as well. So you have to take one whole cup of any cheap rice, we have to use 3 cups in total, 2 and 3. And I'm going to use 1 cup of urad dal, that is white dal, which you use for medhi vadas. I'm going to use the urad dal, 1 cup in a separate pan. And then I need flattened rice, that is poha. You get in any Indian shops, all these things. I'm going to wash it separately. I'm going to take the water and wash the rice using my hands nicely. You have to wash it really nicely. I have washed the rice nicely. Let me show you. And I'm just going to use 1 cup of water to soak the rice for about 10 to 12 hours. I don't need more than that. I'm going to wash the urad dal as well. Nice. I have washed the urad dal nicely. And I'm going to put 1 cup of water and soak it for 10 to 12 hours, same as the rice. Now this is the puffed rice which I showed you, the poha. I'm going to wash this as well. I'm going to put the poha in my urad dal. Remember, I had put 1 cup of water, but I'm not going to put any water in this. I'm just going to add it. Add this, and then I'm also going to add methi seeds, that's fenugreek seeds. 1 spoon of fenugreek seeds in the batter. That's all. And can you see, I'm going to leave it like this, the rice and this, for 10 to 12 hours. Hello friends, can you see, after 12 hours, this is how the rice looks. And this is how the puffed rice and the urad dal looks with the fenugreek leaves. Now I'm going to use my hand blender to make a fine paste. Can you see how the batter looks? I put the rice, urad dal and fenugreek seeds and the poha, the rice flakes inside this. And I'm going to rest this batter for 10 to 12 hours. Can you see how the batter has fermented? I'm going to keep the batter aside and I'm going to turn on the gas, and I'm going to put 2 glasses of water and let the cooker boil. Let the water boil. While this is happening, I'm going to make the coconut chutney. I'm going to use coconut, 1 big coconut and 100 grams of coriander. I'm putting clarified butter. That is ghee, just a little bit, and then I'm putting my batter in. Can you see, like this? And I'm putting 2 kajus inside it, cashew nuts, and then putting little batter to cover it. I'm just going to close it like this and put it in my cooker, and then close the cooker for 15 minutes. While the idli is being made, I have the coriander. I washed the coriander and the coconut and the jalapeno, and I'm going to put it in my blender. I'm going to put some coconut water and some 2 spoons of salt, and I use 4 jalapenos. I'm going to turn off the gas now. It's been 15 minutes, and let it cool down. And while the idlis were being made, I also made the coconut and the coriander chutney. I'm going to put it in here. Look, I'm opening it now and I'm going to check it. Oh, it's done. It's all clear. I'm going to keep it to cool like this for 5 minutes. It's been 5 minutes now, and I'm going to remove the idlis. you see the cashew nuts in between? Can you see? I'm going to try some. It's really nice, soft and spongy. Hope you like it. Thank you for watching.